people. It's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody moving.
I don't see. What can you learn from a bum, Omar? Chancellor Dean? What I learned from a bum, maybe it's what not to do.
Up and up seven easy. There's a reason why after 100 channels destroyed, Angel Snuff Nuff 7 is still here. There's a reason, but you don't take me seriously.
Wrote a song about it? Like to hear it? Here it go!
Free your mind! People all over the world!
See, they say that Angel Snuff Nuff 7 don't care about the people. But Angel Snuff Nuff 7 cares about the people because I'm bold enough to tell you the truth and I don't give a damn if you give me a dime. I'm not looking for your money.
Prejudice. Wrote a song about it? Like to hear it? Here it go.
Free your mind.
This is a story about control. My control. Control of what I say and control of what I do. and this time I'm gonna do it my way. I hope you enjoy this as much as I do. Are we ready? I am. 'Cause it's all about control. And I've got lots of it.
My Negroes don't have. If I'm gonna die, I'll die now, right here fighting you. If I'm gonna die, you my enemy. My enemies are white people, not Viet Cong or Chinese or Japanese. You my opposer when I want freedom. You my opposer when I want justice. You my opposer when I want equality. You won't even stand up for me in America for my religious beliefs, and you want me to go somewhere and fight, but you won't even stand up for me here at home.
No, I don't worry. I tell you, I'm a man who believed that I died 20 years ago. And I live like a man who is dead already. I have no fear whatsoever of anybody.
seems to me that white America must see that no other ethnic group has been a slave on American soil. That America freed the slave in 1863 through the Emancipation Proclamation, but gave the slaves no land. And at the same time, America was giving away millions of acres of land in the West and the Midwest, which meant that there was a willingness to give the white peasants from Europe an economic base. And yet it refused to give its black peasants from Africa, who came here involuntarily in chains and had worked free for 244 years, any kind of economic base. And so emancipation for the Negro was really freedom to hunger. And when white Americans tell the Negro to lift himself by his own bootstraps, it's a cruel jest to say to a bootless man that he ought to lift himself by his own bootstraps.
I'm saying that the Nation of Islam should evolve into what we call the Reality's Temple on Earth.
Talking about not falling into the teacher trap, not falling into the website trap. So today, what teachers can you learn from? We just told you that the Aka Wu tells you that we're all a great teacher at the same time. So who are you going to learn from? You're going to learn from brothers like Sarnetta. You're going to learn the positives and negatives from brothers like Sarnetta. You're going to learn the positives and negatives of people like Brother Polite. The positives and negatives of people like Sarah Sutton Seti. You're going to learn from Maurice Muhammad, Talik Ibn Rad. You're going to learn from Netter Cat. You're going to learn. You definitely going to learn from King Noble. You definitely going to learn a little something, something from Brother Daku.
My black people, it's all about the unity and the unity.
Emergency.
Prejudice.
Wrote a song about it? Like to hear it? Here it go.
Real.
Cause I keeps it real like that. I keeps it real.
Check it out, check it out, y'all. Southern girls in the house, you don't hear me though. Check it out, check it out.
I am also your soul brother, number one.
My brother Angel Snubnub 7 at the Reality Temple. And to give props to him, because I listen to all of Angel Snubnub 7's videos, I think that he comes from a different angle. And there's a powerful message in a lot of the videos that he put out, and I try to catch all of them. I look at him as a free thinker and a person that's willing to challenge those of which he don't agree with or which he may think differently from, and I really respect him for that. He's challenged KNBS, and he has also challenged the black supremacy movement as well. And I have nothing against that, because that which cannot be challenged cannot stand and will not stand and will not survive the test of time. How many challenges we can withstand will determine how long we will be able to stand.
Himself, and you don't realize it. You don't realize it, that God has been in prison. The devil was able to imprison God. So right inside your own self, your God self has been in prison, and you have a false sense of self running rampant inside the temple. This is why, you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
You have to bring Reality's temple here on earth. Reality's temple here on earth.
Yes, sir.
We have to realize the enemy is running rampant inside this temple.
And that is Brother Talik from the Reality Temples on Earth channel. And if you get a chance to subscribe, please do subscribe to his channel. He's a good brother. You know, he's doing good work, and he wants to do good constructive things. He has good information to provide. So please do check out his channel if you get a chance.
About the unity, there's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody move for me. Like at the King, we make it plain and simple. Bringing knowledge and fire at Reality's temple. Reality's temple. My black people, it's all about the unity, there's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody move for me. Like at the King, we make it plain and simple. Bringing knowledge and fire.
Let's see, Talik says, can you send a shout out to my platform, the Reality's Temple on Earth Internet Ministry? Our theme this year is After Purge Comes the Healing. Self, shout out to your platform, Talik. All the best to you guys with continuing to stretch in perspective, to stretch in what is possible, and to continue to bring healing into the space of yourself and others. Yes.
Good evening, soul brothers and sisters. This is Tangie Cox, the Black Sheep. And I am propositioning you to entertain just a little while of being in reality. And this is gonna hurt soul sisters and brothers, because a lot of us cannot accept reality. I empower you to, for 1 year, to subscribe to the Reality Temple on Earth. And at the end of 12 months, draw your conclusion of what have you learned in that amount of time. I empower you. You will never, ever, ever think, feel, or entertain nonsense ever again, period. I would like to see my soul sisters and brothers awaken. This requires time. You need to spend about a year watching, researching, and looking. The Reality Temple on Earth is life-changing, and I stand on that.
Everybody who is black and interested in black people, let us sit down and find out how we can get together in one direction against one enemy and accomplish this job overnight.
When soul singer and black activist Sam Cooke wrote the lyrics to his song, A Change Is Gonna Come, it was very direct and to the point. With some changes to it, the song was still digestible. In the year 2019, black folks continue to go through the change rather than direct the change. A community activist named Talik Ibn Rod has made an appeal similar to what Sam Cooke was asking for. A change. It's said that the meek shall inherit the earth, we ask when. When will the landlords give the meek a free lease? Mr. Ebenrod is humbly asking for the state of Mississippi. This is Dusty Basement Studios, and we approve of this message.
The Mississippi campaign represents everything that you claim that you want. The beginning of an all-black independent nation. The ability to control your own resources. Your politics. The law. Be able to do your own thing for a change. Create an economy. Create and produce goods that Africa or anybody on the planet would want. You're fake, you don't want to do nothing. 3 hours talking about the Mississippi campaign.
States, the construct of racism was created specifically to oppress black people, to try to suppress our determination to achieve liberation. Like Angela Davis said, it's built into the system.
Nowadays I can't believe what's going on in front of me. I don't want to watch TV and find another casualty. I don't want to read the news. My heart's already black and blue. I'm putting on my combat boots, 'cause I got an attitude. We're like soldiers forced to fight a war. What the hell? I can't take it anymore. 'Cause for so long we've been patient, now we're done. And don't you even ask me when did I become such an angry black woman.
We can't successfully put an end to racial discrimination until we change the entire system.
We've been trying to keep the peace 50 years since Martin King. Some don't like me for who I am, but I love my melanin. Another future college grad sleeping in a body bag. Mother screaming out her lungs, she never gonna see her son. We're like soldiers forced to fight a war. What the hell? I can't take it anymore. 'Cause for so long we've been patient, now we're done. And don't you even ask me when did I become such an angry black woman.
Lose. Started quickly.
Wrote a song about it? Like to hear it? Here it go.
Free your mind.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
one of the things that I was taught in the Nation of Islam, one of the things that, may he rest in peace, one of the things that Brother Malcolm X was taught, one of the things that every fruit of Islam was taught in the Nation of Islam, we must protect our women. That's what we're taught at all costs. We must protect our women. Why? Because of her extreme value. Teaching this and practicing this is two different things. Like many of you in religion, you are taught against drinking and gambling and so many things, but you find some way to justify. Or I backslid for a few minutes. Oh, marijuana comes from God. It's a plant, and God made the plants. We find ways to justify our behavior. Talking, saying one thing and doing another. If we read Message to the Black Man in America, there's a lot of focus on the importance and the protection of womanhood. But if you do it, it might be a problem, because it's according to who is in violation. If it's me and my wife, and one day I decide you need to shut up, boom, slap, give you a back slap.
Brother, you ain't supposed to do that. Protect the black woman. No, that.
And the mighty, mighty fruit of Islam might find out about it. You're supposed to go before the officials or whomever, or even the Honorable Elijah Muhammad himself, and they decide, brother, we're going to have to suspend you. We're going to have to ostracize you from our group for 90 days. Or a year, or maybe forever, because you don't beat up on the black woman. However, the rule does not fit for everybody, because of the leadership, certain men violate, it's a different story. And this is what got Malcolm X in trouble, because he was only acting upon what he was taught, protect the black woman. But the violator is the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. So since it's the leader, we say one thing and practice another. In this country, I want to talk to the women. In this country, there are a lot of men that tell you, and they pretend they are heterosexual. and they would tell you, I love you. And you fine, baby. I love women. Saying one thing and doing another. Well, if you love the woman, then why in 2024 she still is underpaid for doing the same job a man does? Why is she still beneath your foot? Because if I love you, I don't want you beneath my foot. I want you equal to me. I don't want you walking behind me. We are walking together, saying one thing and doing another. You're a liar. I want to tell you, woman, regardless of your race, I want to tell you, just because a man get babies by you, just because he licked on you, does not mean he loved you. These men have been conditioned to love their penis. You are nothing but a vessel that's supposed to serve them. A slave to them. That's why your work is called domestic work or slavery. Theirs is real work. Taking care of children, take care of the home, that's not real work. What men do is real work. I give accolades. I praise women that deal with children properly. Because I understand the patience. I understand the women who are nursing. And you have people defecating on themselves. You have women working with people. You have to give grown people baths and things of that nature. Oh, but woman's work ain't nothing compared to what men do. You see the male homosexuality. But homosexuality is on different levels. See, that is physical, and that's mental or spiritual, whatever you say. And they come out in the, these men come out in the open and they would tell you, I love another man. But then you have these men who really don't love you. They're in love with the penis. That's why they will step up and defend the rights of men and what men do. What brings me to this subject, because I seen something real sickening. And you see this behavior in men because they hate womanhood. The recent overturning of this guy, what's his name? Harry Weinstein. He was found guilty of decades of raping women. Decades taking advantage of women. This is not shocking. I remember when I was growing up, it's like it's a joke. Remember there was something called the casting couch. And the reason why there's a casting couch, because the men control Hollywood. So if you want to be in the movies, or if you just want some kind of job, get on the couch. Been raping women for decades. Not only it's a part of American culture. Used to joke about it and laugh about it, the casting couch. Because the men controlled these things. And nowadays you have, of course, their first argument is going to be, you have women that do the same thing and blah, blah, blah. Who started it? They started the casting couch. And so, what brings me to this conversation is I saw this sick comment because the women saw the injustice. But it was a technical thing in law. It can happen. But he's a rapist. But they feel as though because since that was overturned, he should be set free. Unknown, this man is convicted of, he's a rapist. But the hate of men is so much, that's some kind of injustice. So the men find all kinds of excuses to support these rapists. Bill Cosby, that guy, what's his name, that raped all those young gymnasts. And they find all kinds of reasons. That ain't fair. That's not right. And men in this country have been doing that for decades. Laughing and sniggling and giggling. But when justice comes, now folks starting to get upset. You know why you get upset? Because they want to rape you. They want to be in the same position to violate you because I'm a man. And I can do whatever the hell I want to womanhood. And then they'll go to their wives and their daughters and smile and skin and grin in your face. You don't even like women. That's why most times you will see a lot of men, my son. It's all about the son. And you're so conditioned by the same stuff. My son. I want to have a son too. I got all these. I want a son. I got to have a son. Because you have been conditioned to hate yourself. I got to have that son. And who's the main one? Who's the main one that usually getting the education? Who's the main one that's usually trying to do right? The son end up a damn drunk. The son end up being a serial killer. The son end up in prison, in jail, in the mental institution. But he's the best. My son. The rapist. You always have folks that want to be better. They want to be inferior. Folks are always looking for a slave. Always want this feeling of being better, having an advantage over others. They don't, these men don't like you. You don't even like yourself. Because women stand up for women and you don't even support them. Have some dignity for yourself. There you go on the damn strip pole. There you go selling your backside on the streets. Not even helping your own gender. Doing all this freaky stuff for the entertainment of men because that's what you are. You're nothing but a tool for them. You mean nothing to them. And you think that he's a heterosexual. And he's a homosexual too. In fact, some of them are down low. They will go to bed with you and go out into the night and visit another man. We know this. How you gonna get upset with Malcolm X because he done what he was taught? Stand up for the black woman. How you gonna get upset because it might look like a rapist is being done unjustly. He's a rapist. That's because they don't love womanhood. They don't want you to have nothing. You are a slave to them. Their religion backs them up. But you don't know any better. And you've been under this control for thousands of years. They don't mind you as long as you stay in your place. What is your place? Your place is barefoot and pregnant. Don't you try to be like me. Don't you try to get what I got. There was a time when women screamed rape and basically it fell on deaf ears. What did you do? You did something to deserve. You did something to tempt this man. And now the men are upset because finally you're getting some justice, just like the racists. The racists get upset because black folks getting some justice. But you have been doing this for hundreds of years. Now you want to get upset because your victims are getting some justice. Because you want to be a slave owner. Because you want to rape somebody and get away with it. How many of you women are sleeping with men? As long as you don't want nothing, they cool, but don't try to get what I got. I'm the authority. I'm the dictator. My penis make me smarter than you. Shut your damn mouth. I run this house. I run this family. But he's a drunk. He's a crackhead. It don't make no difference. I got a penis. A penis has special powers. And that's what it's all about. This patriarchal civilization has these men gay. You think homosexuality just popped up out of the woodworks? It came because of it's the consequence. It's the exposure of a behavior at its pinnacle. They worship their own penis. But the Honorable Elijah Muhammad was teaching, protect the black woman and her value. How are you going to do it? But if you actually really do that, then it lessens, you feel as though it lessens yourself as a man. So that's nothing. So it's all talk. You know when somebody really loves you. These men are conditioned not to love you as a woman. You're nothing but a slave. You're domestic. You're just a tool. So they can enjoy other men.
People always do me. Be careful what they do. Don't go around picking young girls' hearts. He and mother always told me, be careful with your love. Be careful what you do. When your love become the truth, hey, I feel it, Jane. It's not my love. She's just a girl who claims that I am the one. But the kid is not my son. She says I am the one. Oh no, but the kid is not my son. I ain't impressed.
The deacon said, imagine how Michael Jackson felt when he told Joseph, I want out of the Jackson 5. Michael wanted his freedom.
And I'm making this particular video about the Reality's Temple and how it changed my views and some of my concepts about life. But first, I want to say that I want to thank Angel Snubnub 7 for being there for me, administering to me over YouTube and in person, over the phone. The brother believed in me to make these videos. He gave me the opportunity. He gave me the free will to make these videos that I make in association with the Reality Temple on Earth. I want to say that if I would have had a brother like this in my life 10, 15 years ago, I probably wouldn't have took the path that I took.
I'm not really worried about convincing you about what I believe in. My main concern is to find people with the like-minded minds, like Minister, the Realist Temple, the Reality's Temple on Earth. I can relate with that guy. I can say he's talking sense because he has intelligence and he doesn't come up with rubbish. He comes up with well-thought conversations. He's thought about this. He's still thinking about it as right now as we speak about it. And after that, he'll be thinking about it because he's a thinker. He's not just a doer taking information and repeating it. He's a thinker. He's been intrigued. His mind's been intrigued by reality, by things on earth that have woken him up. So enough respect to him.
I do want to say something right now. There is a YouTuber who has really got in my heart, and that is Angel Snubnub 7. He reminds me a lot of my father. My father died last year of a heart attack, and Angel Snubnub 7.
There was a time within my lifetime, 50, 60 years ago, there was something called the Civil Rights Movement. There was something called Black Revolution Movement. And we heard the names of many persons like Dr. Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, Elijah Muhammad, Fannie Lou Hamer, Stokely Carmichael, Eldridge Cleaver, Fred Hampton, Huey P. Newton, and so many known and unknown. I was a child born in Jim Crow and too young to really participate in the activity of civil rights or Black Revolution type behavior. I was born towards the end of what we know of as Jim Crow. During this period of time, it was estimated the population of the so-called or the once called Negro in this country, the population was about 18 to 20 million soul brothers and sisters in this nation. during the time of what we call the Civil Rights Movement, Black Revolutionary Movement. Now, what is really sad, only a very small portion of the 18 to 20 million in this country actually participated, although they benefited from the activity of a few. Maybe not even a million. Out of 18 to 20 million soul brothers and sisters in this nation, maybe a million, 10%. It wasn't very many. You could tell it wasn't very many that participated in this activity that benefit the whole 18 to 20 million. We even saw children, not adults, we saw a lot of children that actually participated in the Civil Rights Movement. They came out of their school and went to jail and were treated like adults by the racists. But these was children willing to fight. I was too young myself to know all these things, but as soon as I began to understand as a child, I wanted to participate in the fight. But again, a small handful of persons compared to the 18 to 20 million in this nation. You know who I'm talking about, because that's the majority. The majority benefit from the sacrifice, the suffering of the minority. The majority did nothing, and you should be, and they should be ashamed of themselves, but there's no shame for a coward and parasite. And we should know this, because many of us today, we have the same attitude. We will watch others struggle. We will watch others sacrifice and suffer, sit on our ass and do nothing. We're like that today. We want somebody else to go to jail. We want somebody else to suffer, and we benefit. So the parasites who benefit, who didn't do a damn thing, believed the war was over, because now I can marry me a white woman. I can marry me a white guy. I can eat at a lunch counter. I understand why pro-black people hate integration and they talk about integration so bad. But that was not the premise. Don't tell that lie. That's what the Civil Rights Movement was about. Marrying Caucasian people and sitting at a lunch counter was all about fighting for equal rights, I want you to treat me. I want to be treated like a man. I want to be treated like a woman, an equal citizen in this nation. It was not about these tiddlywink things. But that's what it turned out to be. And your enemy used their media to paint this picture. That's what it was all about. And excerpts from Dr. King's speeches, where little black boys and little black girls, he did not say, I'm sleeping with your ass. I just want to be treated like a citizen because I earned it. Living in this nation for over 400 years. And I fought in all your wars. and I pay all my taxes. The black man and woman, the soul brothers and sisters in this country, more patriotic than anybody in this land. Proven fact. But not treated and given the benefits of a citizen. That's what it was about. It's not about sleeping with somebody. These folks don't give a damn about giving you their panties. They rape you on the slave plantation. They don't care about sleeping with you. They don't want to give you power. They don't want to give you equality. They don't care about you eating a sandwich at a lunch counter. They don't want you to have the same power. They don't want you to have the same advantages as they do. That's what the movement was about. And these who complain, these who run their mouth, didn't do a damn thing in the struggle. You have the right to complain. You ain't did nothing. You the beneficiary. And you still the beneficiary. You ain't did a damn thing to progress the movement. You haven't won any more battles. So the children who come after these fighters, the children who benefit from those who did fight, I'm comfortable. I can get me a good job. I can go to school with them. Because of the few little gains, there's a sense of being comfortable, illusion. I finally get my piece of the pie. So you marry Caucasian people and you go to parties with Caucasian people and you integrated. It's all lovey-dovey now. And the generation that come after tell you, I ain't like my mama. I ain't like my racist daddy and my racist grandfathers. We're not like that. We gonna change things in this country. We gonna change things. And so now you hear them cry. You hear them complain. Because they snigger and they skin and grin in their new white friend. I got white friends. A disclaimer, everybody not the same. Because there are those Caucasian people who will treat you as you should be treated. But of course, those in power who you thought was different from their mama and their daddy, they don't mind giving you some ding-a-ling. They don't mind giving you their poutine. They don't care about all that. They don't care because you eat a sandwich. But they're not going to give you any power. What you don't understand, and now you hear certain spoiled ass leeches complaining, how come they not treating us? We still struggling. I thought we go to the same concerts y'all go to. We married white folks. You're still not treating us. They ain't supposed to. Your Bible even said you are your father the devil, and the works of your devil they shall do. They're the same. And the reason why they're going to stay the same, no matter how you skin and grin and whatever you feel this relationship that you got, the bottom line is they enjoy the position of having an advantage over you. And these fake black men will agree until they are put in a position of advantage, because they don't want women to have the opportunities that they do. People like having advantage over others. This is why they're not going to do that. They're not going to fight white racism. They're not going to fight white supremacy. Because it's easy to do. It's not difficult. But I'm not going to do it because I enjoy having a bigger house than you. Being able to travel more than you can. I enjoy the law will let me do certain things that you can't do. Folks enjoy privilege. I even heard, or I was told by a Caucasian person, yeah, I enjoy my privilege. I enjoy having advantages over you. They said it outright. I enjoy it. So they're not going to go all out their way because of you. Who the hell are you? Because they don't like you like that. They don't love you like that. That's in your imagination. You are real about yours. You are real about equality. You are real about equal citizenship. You are real about being an American. They are not. So when Donald Trump starts coming up, you begin to see the real them. Let's win America back. They want it to be like the old days. And what was the old days for you and me? On a slave plantation. Lynched from a tree. Facing discrimination. And all kinds of oppression. It was good for them. And when you walk down the street, you better look down on the ground. Let's go back. Let's go back to the good old days. And now I hear the children of these leeches, because you ain't did a damn thing to fight for no rights or anything. If it was up to you, we'd still be on a slave plantation. So now I hear them complaining. These Caucasian people, they're just like their parents. Of course they are. So what you gonna do about it? You're not gonna do nothing except tolerate it like your cowardly, happy-ass parents done. Waiting on somebody else to fight. Somebody else to suffer. And your funky little children benefit from somebody else suffering and sacrifice. That's why I refuse and will no longer participate in that type of behavior. I'm not here to save nobody. How can you go to sleep? And then what do you do for Dr. King? You make a statue and you give a name a street. Who gives a damn? That don't help nobody because you name a street after a dead man. Make a statue of a dead man. But you haven't done nothing to progress his work so that his dream could come true. And the choice is either you get that done or you need to strive to separate yourself from these hypocrites, because that's what they are. And you need to take your destiny in your own hands. Or just admit and just continue to be the damn slave and tolerate like our ancestors did. Yes, sir, Massa. That ain't right, Massa. They don't care because you angry and upset. It took thousands of us to go into the streets and fight this battle to change this. They're not going to change nothing unless you're ready to go for a battle. but you ain't gonna do nothing. And the only way that you can actually get into, make progress, is with this vision that we bring here called the Mississippi Campaign. Because you put yourself in a position, either we will be treated as equal citizens, or we're putting ourselves in a position to exodus the hell out. One or the other. You need to take your destiny in your own hands. If you are a man, if you're one, but if you are a slave, like the majority was and is, you didn't fight. There are very few of us that can say, my ancestor walked with Fannie Lou Hamer or Dr. King. They didn't participate. The majority of us are nothing but leeches. We benefit from somebody else's sweat, blood, and tears. Me personally, I feel shame. So what you gonna do? What you gonna do? Because ain't nobody in no hurry to save your happy ass. Except reality, my friend, is much easier.
This video is for the Reality Temple on Earth.
Shout out to the Reality Temple on Earth on IG.
We love watching it.
Yeah, we really do.
We send love, peace, and soul.
There's been so many things that's held us down, but now it looks like things are finally coming around. I know we've got a long, long way to go, and where we'll end up, I don't know. But we won't let nothing hold us back. We're putting our show together, we're polishing up our act. And if you've ever been held down before, I know you refuse to be held down anymore.
Of Islam should evolve into what we call the Reality's Temple on Earth. You don't need no Arab hand-me-down religion. You don't even need God. You don't need these things. In our infancy, in our immaturity, when we was babies. But as we grow and mature, and even in religion itself, it says that we are the children of God. Children can't stay children forever. Children must become adults. So if we are the children of God, that means we become God. Act like God, move like God, and have the responsibility of a God. when we come into this world, contrary to popular belief, we know nothing. We don't even know that we are alive. Everything about us is automatic. And the only thing that this automation causes us to do is seek food, seek comfort. That's all. No more, no less. All of us. Nobody is born a history professor. Nobody is born a police officer. Nobody is born a teacher. Nobody is born a Muslim. Nobody is born a Hebrew. We are born, we come into this life with nothing. We're not wearing no clothes. We come butt naked. We're not wearing a diaper. We have absolutely nothing. This is facts. We don't even know we're alive. But as we mature, as we grow, we start to come into our own. And if you were little Michael Jackson, may he rest in peace. If you were Michael Jackson, you was born in a world of poverty, but you're too young. You don't know about poverty. You just happy and you're just a child. You are born in an environment where your father loves music. You are born in an environment where your mother loves music. You are born into a musical environment. A God-fearing, as you would say, environment. And so as Michael began to evolve and he began to grow, that began to influence him. And he began to notice parts of himself that engaged this music and brought him joy. And he could navigate this music. So it's not a surprise and it's not shocking that Michael Jackson would want to grow up and would move towards entertainment or music, because this is what influenced his life. He was inspired and he was motivated. And folks saw the connection between Michael and music. So he was encouraged. And then you have somebody like Venus and Serena Williams. Father looking for somebody he could teach this tennis. I got an idea. I can't play, but I got this idea. And he tried it on other children. They just didn't get it. But the concept, the influence, was introduced to Venus and Serena, and something about them, they said, I like this, and they gravitate toward that. And so it's no shock that they become superstars of tennis, being influenced. But they came onto the earth knowing nothing. We are here. And the reason why we are who we are because of our experience and influence in life. Some things we gravitate towards, some things we don't. I was born around people who like to drink liquor. And in most cases, if you are around liquor, if you're around smoking and drinking and cussing and all this, the child will gravitate and become a part of that too. Because that's the environment that influenced them. I chose not to do that. I did not see anything exciting about drinking and smoking and fornicating and all that. And I didn't have nothing to do with church. I found out in church, fornication, adultery, drinking, that was bad stuff. But it had nothing to do with the church. I just did not like it. I just did not gravitate towards it. I was influenced by the television. I liked the entertainment. I liked the writing the different stories and the cartoons. I want to do that. I want to draw. I want to make cartoons. I want to write for television. That was my first thing that I was influenced by, the television. I want to be an entertainer, but I want to write. I had this imagination I could come up with these stories real quick. Quality stories. My stories were so good, it even entertained my mother. That sounded just like one of my soap operas. And I was just a little boy. I just copied the soap opera, the television, began to understand how to write these stories and make up these characters. But something in your life, something changes you, something turns you around. I did not come to YouTube to become the realityist temple on earth. I had no thought about that. But clearly, it's a part of me that I had to make manifest because it's me. Because of the influence, because of the environment that I grew up in. I remember getting ready to go to church one Sunday. And our parents never made us go to church, but they was going to church. I want to go to church too. I don't want to be at home with the chickens and the pigs. I want to go to church too. You want to leave home. You're usually at home all the time. I want to go somewhere outside of home. I want to go to church too. And my mother found one of my father's old suits, and one of the ladies was there to help us go to church and dress us up. And when the lady put me in my suit and dressed me all up, because I didn't know how to wear a suit, our little boy, she said, "Look at the little preacher." I'm like, "What?" Now I'm going to church. I don't know what a preacher, I don't know what a pastor, I don't know what a minister is. But something about what she said, I look like a pastor. What is that? But something about it, I don't even know what it is. It struck a chord. And as time goes on, it was still there. And then I was introduced to the struggle by my Caucasian teacher. She said that your people were slaves in this country. I'm like, what? Because my folks never taught us nothing. I began to learn about the struggle. I began to learn about Jim Crow by my white teacher, Caucasian teacher in school. Parents didn't teach us, grandpa, grandma, cousins, nobody. They was living this, never taught us nothing that was going on in the Jim Crow South. I had to learn it from my Caucasian teacher. And I became a little rebel. Because that's wrong. And see, this is why, one of the reasons why we really cannot get anything going is because we don't feel nothing. We're not real about liberation. We're not real about the struggle. It don't really mean, it really don't mean. See, you have to like it. You got to live it. Some people tell, I live. No, you don't. Because if you actually lived it, you know that you have to unify. You got to unify with your brothers and sisters. Dr. Claude Anderson tell you all the time, but you don't give a damn. You don't listen because you all about what you want. Racism is a team sport. They play like a team. So in order to deal with a team, you got to become a team. The Nation of Islam is not going to win this fight. The More Science Temple is not going to win this fight. FBA is not going to win this fight. You have to become a team. And if you're not interested in unity, you're talking bull doo-doo. And so I was later influenced by the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad as I continue to grow up. I'm still interested in singing and dancing and all that entertainment stuff. But that's not where my heart is. Michael Jackson's heart was singing and dancing. Did it to the day that he passed this earth. Venus and Serena, their heart is the tennis. They don't care nothing about it. They can open all the other businesses and whatever. That's not, I want to play tennis. I want to sing and dance. Michael Jordan, I want to play basketball. He did it till he couldn't do it no more. Muhammad Ali boxed until he couldn't do it no more. That's where your heart lies. That activity developed you. There are those trying to be Mr. Leader. I want to lead the black people. I'm the leader of black people. They're trying to. The best leader are those who not even trying. I didn't want to. Malcolm X didn't. It was not his desire to be some leader. Dr. King, that was not his intent, desire to be some type of leader, except of the church, a spiritual leader of the church. These people that want to be leaders, they have no creativity, they have no imagination, they have no vision, they have no goal, they have no purpose. Because they're not leaders. You have people in leadership positions. They're not leadership material. This is why this country is in anarchy. I'm a leader simply because people like me. I'm popular. But they demonstrate no leadership skills, no leadership quality. I was put in positions. I never want to be a leader. I never wanted to manage nothing. I always was put in situations where I had no choice. You are the leader. You got to manage. I don't want to do it. You got to do it. And I found out I could do it. I remember one of my management jobs. I was assistant manager. I did not want to be manager. I did not want his job. But I could see where he could do better. And I suggested to him, and like many of you, you don't like suggestions. You don't like advice. But the difference between him and you got a big mouth. telling me what I should and should not do. Well, show me. I'm going to make you manager for a day. Let's see what you do, since you know more than I do. I did not say that, sir. I'm just telling. No, you show me. So he put me in that position. I increased the profits for that day. I had a better relationship with the other employees. I showed him a better way to produce the product with less labor costs. And the only thing he could do was say, thank you. That's all he did. I have really tried to remove myself from YouTube. I cannot do it. Every time I try to do it, somebody flag my channel or do something, that makes me fight. Or somebody send me an email, I don't want you to go. It's just one person, but I don't want you to go. Stay here. But the thing about it is they just want me to stay here and talk, but you won't help me in the work. You want me to stay here and talk, but you don't want to get off your ass and help me with the work. You just want me to hear to continue to just talk. There's a lot of work. There's a lot of things that need to be done besides talking. Why? But you don't want to. But see, I enjoy. This is what I enjoy. I like this. The same way like Michael Jackson loved to sing. The same way Michael Jordan loved to play basketball. And Serena and Venus, they like to play tennis. It don't make any difference whether you listen to me or not. As long as I have something to say, I want to say it, and I enjoy speaking my word. But my word is no benefit to you if you don't act upon the wisdom that your God has blessed. But you have a problem because I'm not in the vessel, I'm not in the form that you believe. Yet it's still at the same time you say that your God told you, my sheep know my voice. Don't you hear your God calling? But you won't respond. Because you really don't believe what you're talking about. You really don't believe. Because you shouldn't care. Here we are, we've been blessed with the answer. It's not for me, it's not for a certain group. It's for us to get out of this situation once and for all. I came unto my own, and my own received me not. But like a brother told me, the soul train rolls on. Because it's not about you. It's about me. My conscience is clear. As long as I do my job, I'm cool. We'll be right back.
talking about not falling into the teacher trap, not falling into the website trap. So today, what teachers can you learn from? We just told you that the Aka Wu tells you that we're all a great teacher at the same time. So who are you going to learn from? You're going to learn from brothers like Sarnetta. You're going to learn the positives and negatives from brothers like Sarnetta. You're going to learn the positives and negatives of people like Brother Polite. The positives and negatives of people like Sarah Sutton Seti. You're going to learn from Maurice Muhammad, Talik Ibn Rod. You're going to learn from Netterkat. You're going to learn. You're definitely going to learn from King Noble. You definitely going to learn a little something something from Brother Daku.
Hey, Umar! Not to be popular. It's just I'm inspired by my brother, that Reality Temple's brother, the most powerful voice on the internet, that Real Angel Snubbing Up 7. That's right, brother. I'm calling you out, brother. I'm building you. I'm putting you out there, brother. I'm shouting you out. That's my inspiration.
I question human intelligence. I am taught that the human being is the most intelligent life form on this planet. I question that. I question that. Because you are intelligent, yes. You are intelligent as far as the ability to make machines and take what is in your imagination and make it a reality. We are very intelligent. But yet and still, we get drunk and we get high and we do things that is contrary to supposed to be somebody that's supposed to have this high intelligence. We still cannot solve our problems. We have to turn to war, cussing and profanity and violence. What type of intelligence that we represent? I don't. An intelligent evil? What type of high intelligence are you? Because in the fictional Batman, the Joker is intelligent, but he's intelligent in an evil manner, a wicked manner. I question the intelligence of human beings, and I am guilty myself, especially when we get caught up in spirituality and beliefs and even so-called black scholarship. Because we take the teachings, we take these beliefs, and they supersede common sense. They supersede logic and being analytical and reason, being rational. It overcomes the obvious. I want to explain, where are you going with this? Here we are. believe stories of dead people walking around and demons and spirits. A man can walk on water. You ain't never seen that in your life. But these teachers tell you that this is possible, and it happened a long time. You never seen it. It happened a long time ago. And there's no evidence that it happened a long time ago. But we just are told to believe. We reject what we know. We have never seen this. We embrace that. Because these teachings are factual. These teachings are real. These teachings are supersede anything we learn in college, anything that we learn in grade school, anything that we can actually experience in our life. These teachings. Well, it didn't happen to me. I don't see it around me, but I believe it. I believe this stuff. I'm guilty too, because as a young person growing up, I was attracted to biology because I wanted to study nature. I wanted to get into that type of science. And in the Nation of Islam, I was taught that the peanut is, you cannot eat peanuts. We cannot eat peanuts in the Nation of Islam because it's a nut, and nuts take 5 years of your life. How do you calculate that? How can you calculate that peanuts or any nuts take 5 years of your life unless you know or have an idea how long you're going to live? And hell, by the time some of us even began to understand what Islam was, we've ate so many nuts, because it says every time you eat peanuts, it takes 5 years of your life. If that's the case, we should have been dead a long time ago, because it doesn't take that long for us to eat a certain amount of peanuts, and we don't have life left, because every time you eat peanuts, it takes 5 years off your life. How do you calculate that? But the peanut is not a nut. The peanut is an underground legume. It's a pea. It's not a nut. Nuts come from trees. Almonds, pecans, Brazil nuts. They come from trees. That's nuts. Peanuts don't come from trees. But under these teachings, I just ignored it like y'all do, like we do. We just ignored that, knowing that the peanut is not a nut. But I just ignored it. I'm not going to eat no peanuts. And at the time, I like peanut butter, but I can't eat no peanut butter because that's a nut. Take 5 years off your life. How do you calculate that? Then we're taught Jesus died for our sins. Jesus died for our sins. Jesus died for our sins. But then the same Bible turn around and tell you nobody can die for your sin. Now we got to make this contradiction. And we know this, but we ignore it and go with the narrative that we believe, the teaching that we've accepted. Well, how can a perfect God, and you say God never changed, first God gonna tell you nobody can die for your sin, then turn around and say Jesus died for your sin. We embrace this. I question the intelligence of human beings. So it's mind-boggling. I was taught in the Nation of Islam, I'm taught the white man is the devil. And when you are oppressed, when somebody's doing you bad, that's easy to accept. Yeah, he's a devil. There's people call me a devil because they felt as though I done them wrong. But the white man is the ultimate devil. He's the evil that created all the evil. White man's the devil. That's what I'm taught. The white man is a devil by nature. What is nature? you know the white man is a devil by nature? In order to understand the nature of an animal, you have to see that animal in the natural environment. You've never seen Caucasian people because you say they came from the hillsides and caves of Europe. You did not see them in the hillsides and caves of Europe. So you don't know what their behavior is. You have no idea what their nature is. Only thing you know is your interaction with them. And anybody that do us wrong, we would call them a devil. A devil by nature. I had to start questioning these things. Because children, white children, Caucasian children, that actually grow up around black folks, if it's their nature, why they don't express it? I can guarantee you, Michael Jackson's children do not act like the average Caucasian person out here in La La Land somewhere, because they was raised 1,000% by black folks, being around black people. My friends, when I was young, a lot of them was Caucasian. They was Caucasian because black people did not like me. I was too black, and I was too poor, and I was too interested in the struggle, and I was too interested in books. So they didn't like Angel Snuffin' Up 7. Caucasian people never made mockery of my skin. They never made mockery of the clothes I was wearing. In fact, they was amazed by my intelligence. Wow, you so smart. I did not get that from the righteous by nature black people. The righteous by nature black people told me how ugly I was because of my dark skin. The so-called righteous people called me the N-word the first time I ever heard it. Made mockery because I was poor in the South. But the white man is the devil by nature. On social media, I've never had a Caucasian person bring up my mama, because you don't know my mama. But on social media, the holy and righteous black people, your mama this and your mama that. On social media, I've never had a Caucasian person tell me, if I find where you at, I'll come to your house and beat your ass. The holy, righteous black person, I'll come to your house and whoop your ass. And they love black people. Here I am, 50, going on 60 or whatever, and you have a young black man or whatever, I'll come to your house, who say I love black people, I'm going to come to your house and beat your ass. I've never had Caucasian people do that. But the white man's the devil. That's what you say. That's what you want us to believe. You've never seen Caucasian people naturally. We've never seen in this modern time going for thousands of years, we've never seen a human being in a natural state. We've seen the human being under the influence of religious teachings and slavery and oppression. We've never seen the human being in a state of being in a natural state. None of you. Nobody on this planet. And the same teaching that tell me the white man is the devil, they said the original righteous black people, what did they do? They rounded up the devils, the Caucasian people, who they made. They made these people through genetic manipulation. The holy and righteous black folks made the devil by genetic manipulation. And then they decided to commit genocide, because they blamed these new people that they made for the trouble among them, with no trial, speculation, allegations, simply because they was new among them. They stripped them of their clothes except something to hide their shame, and walk them across the desert. These are the holy and righteous people. And they even tried to blow up the earth. This is why, according to their story, this is why the moon is out there, because the holy and righteous people put gunpowder in the earth because they was angry, because somebody wanted everybody to speak the same language or something to that effect. And they got mad, so I'm going to blow up the earth. But the white man is the devil and have nuclear weapons right now. Ain't nobody talking about, they talk about blowing up another country. Ain't nobody ever talk about, let's just forget it. I can't have it my way. I'm going to blow up the earth. But the white man is the devil. And we believe this. And in our lifetime, I understand our relationship with Caucasian people. But I also understand we have met folks that have good character. And when it comes to evil, when it comes to nasty things, we see that in humanity, period. You have African folks who are part of the holy and righteous. They are running from Africa, coming here, the land of the devils. Why? Are they running away from the white folks and the Chinese and whoever in Africa? No, they are running from other Africans, the holy and the righteous that you say. Because their nature is of righteousness. If their nature is of righteousness, why are African people running away from them to Europe and to the United States? Whatever weapons these people get, they will do the same thing the white man do. If they could get their hands on a nuclear weapon or whatever type of technology, they do the same thing. And those African people would tell you, even prior to the white man, there was no righteous behavior going on in Africa. There have been tribal wars and murder and rape long before the Europeans showed up on that continent. This is what happens within a patriarchal mindset, whether it's in Europe, whether it's in Asia, Australia, on the African continent, wherever you find men with the patriarchal mindset, you will find this evil that you're trying to blame on one people that's doing nothing no different than any of these other suckers have done. Africans have committed genocide upon Africans. Europeans have committed genocide upon Europeans. Asians have committed genocide upon Asians, and so forth, under the rulership, under the influence of patriarchal civilization and society. But we just want to blame the white man when he's acting no different than any other man on this planet. This is fact. We don't want to talk about that. So of course, you're not related to him if the white man come to Europe. If the white man come to Africa, you don't expect him to treat you all pretty. Plus, according to the teachings, which y'all believe, you march these people butt naked across the desert to Europe. You treated them like hell. So it's not a shock to me that they would want revenge. Wouldn't you want revenge? Matter of fact, you talking about what you would do. You telling your God you want to put the white man in slavery because you want revenge. But nothing happened to you when you do the same damn thing. Contradiction, double standards. But this is how it is within patriarchal civilization and society. So if you want to call anything, anybody evil, call the man, call the male gender evil, because they are the ones behind all of it. That's the common denominator. Because the male gender is corrupt and insane. Because you want to prove that you better and greater and stronger than another man. Your intelligence is no different than male bears fighting and male elephants fighting and all this other. That's how males in the animal kingdom, that's how they act and behave. They got to show I'm dominant.
Let's see, Talik says, can you send a shout out to my platform, the Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry? Our theme this year is After Purge Comes the Healing. So shout out to your platform, Talik. All the best to you guys with continuing to stretch in perspective, to stretch in what is possible, and to continue to bring healing into the space of yourself and others. Yes.
It's the truth. It's actual. Everything is satisfaction.
He's heading your way again. Uncle Remus, the immortal storyteller in Walt Disney's honored motion picture classic.
Now that's the kind of day when you can't open your mouth without a song jump right out of it. Zip-a-dee-doo-da. My, oh my, what a wonderful day.
Singing a song, a song, a song.
I want to start my own. The brother got on my website today and said we need a Pan-African channel. I totally agree. I was working on starting my own video streaming page where you can just load all your videos up there. No time, no censorship. Because if you notice on my website now, it's limited to 100 megabytes. Due to the servers, due to the carrier, the videos can only be no more than 100 megabytes. I'm tired of YouTube. Too many times they're destroying our pages. They don't want to see this movement grow on YouTube. You see some of my videos and you look at them and they're like, got 10 views, 20 views. That's not because, and people will look at that and they'll make them think, oh, he's not getting the views. No, I have so many YouTube pages destroyed that they don't want to see me effectively and successfully build up this momentum and stream of people watching my videos. I'm just as big as the bigger people on YouTube, but you cannot see it because they make it that way by constantly destroying my pages to destroy the momentum that I am building up on YouTube. So it's not going to work on YouTube. You all see how long I've been on YouTube. No one has been more resilient, pushing more harder on YouTube than I have. I must add, Brother Angel Snubnub 7, Brother Talik Ibn Ra, many of you have not heard of him, and it's a reason for that you haven't heard of brothers like that who's coming with a profound message. Every day this brother does like an hour of dissertation on YouTube. But no one's hearing him. His message is not getting out. Powerful message. More powerful than most messages that are out there. Very real, very radical, very sincere, very diligent, very consistent, and very little hypocrisy in what he speaks. At least he's true and sincere about what he's talking about. He's not doing it for money, selling no products, trying to do lectures. He's actually coming on there, offering some critical thought and critical analysis every day consistently, but most people have not heard of him. Not because he's lazy. I see him. He got thousands of YouTube pages. I see him constantly putting out videos. But you haven't heard of him. That's by design. That's by design of white supremacy. That's because you all want to hear the popular message and not the real and raw message. And YouTube makes sure of that. They make sure that they can constantly stomp out your Messiah. They let the Messiah get further enough just for you to hear who the Messiahs are. And as soon as you hear him, bam, they cut off. Damn, job well done. So we have to create our own sites.
Are you all right?
Get away!
yourself and you don't realize it. You don't realize it, that God has been in prison. The devil was able to imprison God. So right inside your own self, your God self has been in prison, and you have a false sense of self running rampant inside the temple. This is why, you understand what I'm saying? You,
yes, sir.
We have to bring reality's temple here on earth. Reality's temple here on earth.
Yes, sir.
We have to realize the enemy is running rampant inside this temple.
And that is Brother Talik from the Reality Temples on Earth channel. And if you get a chance to subscribe, please do subscribe to his channel. He's a good brother. You know, he's doing good work, and he wants to do good constructive things. He has good information to provide. So please do check out his channel if you get a chance.
Woo! Lordy, lordy, lordy. Wow. I don't know where to start. I really don't know where to start. Well, since 2007, I made my first video. And I have been in trouble in these YouTube streets ever since. I've always been told only 10 people listen to me. I've always been told. I mean, since 2007, even though you can find videos with 300, 3,000, 5,000 views, it don't make any difference. Folks always tell me, I'm on Instagram, I'm on Daily Motion, I'm on Vimeo, I'm on Facebook, it don't make any difference. Only 10 people listen to me, and I only get 10 views. It makes you wonder, because there are people who really do get very few views. I mean, really do. 30, 40 views or whatever. They don't really get a lot of attention. Here I am. I only get 10 views. I only have 10 subscribers. But whatever I'm saying, whatever I'm doing, upset people to the point where Google itself get involved. 10 views, 10 subscribers, like, damn. What's up with that? What am I saying? Why am I making folks? I get folks really, really upset. What am I saying? What am I doing to get folks so upset? Because it's mind-boggling. Why would you give attention to somebody with 10 views and 10 subscribers? Why are you going to, if nobody's listening to Angel Snuffin' Up 7, why are you going to spend, go all out your way for copyright infringement, if you can find it. Whatever you can do to try to silence Angel Snuff Number 7. They go all out there. I don't understand. See, you have to think about what's going on here. Why do I get folks upset? I want you dead. Death threats. Ever since 2007, all kinds of death threats. False flagging. Lying on me, slandering, gossip. A person, and then they turn around, ain't nobody listening to you. What? Ain't nobody listening to you. So if nobody listening to me, why are you going all out your way to try to slander, spread gossip, false flag, even got Google involved? Angel Snuff Nuff 7 needs to be destroyed. What the heck? Somebody with 10 subscribers, 10 views. That's the way it's always been ever since 2007. I've reached my pinnacle. What is it that they said? Folks waiting for the downfall. I mean, you already wished death on Angel Snuff Nuff 7 for years. Now we waiting for the downfall. 10 subscribers, 10 views. Okay, now. So now I'm about to bring myself down. Since Google failed to do it, since the demons of darkness, and now we even have some new members of the demons of darkness, they have failed. They can't do nothing. So now I'm going to have to self-destruct. We're waiting on the inevitable downfall of Angel Snuff Nuff 7. What is it that you expect to fall? In order for something to fall, it had to risen to a certain height first in order to gain some kind of height in order to fall, correct? Nothing can fall if it's already on the ground, right? You waiting on, or you want, the inevitable fall of Angel Snuff Nuff 7 when I have never gotten off the ground. Because there have always been forces to keep me on the ground. So how am I going to fall when I've never been up? I cannot fall if I've never been up. I'm like that patch of grass that's trying to grow, and you got cars running over the ground. Every time the grass get a chance, opportunity to try to sprout and get up, here comes some cars, run over it. That's what has been happening to me since 2007. You have not gave me fertilizer. Nobody has given me nothing. Nobody has come to help me to rise. I've always been on the ground. That's how it is with new ideas. That's how it is with the new. That's how it is with those who are different. You have those. Your job is to stunt the growth, and you don't want Angel Snuff Nuff 7. Because see, the thing about it is, once I grow, I never fall. So let's stop him from growing to begin with. So there is no fall. But I'm moving and I'm grooving where you think I have risen and I have not gone anywhere. I'm still the little seed in the earth trying to move the dirt off myself so I can rise. And I will not fall. You don't have the power. You can't do nothing with me on the ground. With all your running over the grass, you can't do nothing. I'm still growing. I'm still dealing with the powers that keep me down. So if you can't stop me, you can't do nothing with me while I'm a seed sprouting, coming up in the earth, what make you think you're going to do something with me when I have risen? Jealousy and envy. That's what it's about. Narcissistic. I'm smarter than you. That's what's wrong with these men with the patriarchal mindset. I got to show you I'm smarter than you. I'm more intelligent than you. That's what it's all about. But then when they come and have to prove it, you're the one that fall. Because you have this illusion that you're high. So you're the one that actually fall. How are you going to deal with somebody who is original, who is creative, that have a vision and a plan and a purpose, and you repeating some stuff and just making up some fabricated ding-dong, ding-a-ling stuff, trying to sound smart? We'll come to the courtroom. Let's see. I pass every test that you put on me. That's why you hate me. That's why you don't like me. But that's the patriarchal mindset. And while you are immature and being a fool, you have men coming across the border. Your children, not mine, because I was smart enough to leave children where they was at. Your children gonna be begging these people that's coming across the border right now for a job. You so smart. How you so smart and you waiting on the great white hope to give you what, really? The great white hope, you might see some kind of benefit in your individual condition, but it does nothing for us as a people. But that's because you're greedy and you're selfish and only looking out for yourself. And then some people do say, I'm the individualist. I'm looking out for myself. I'm looking out for my family. It's about what I want. So what the hell are you talking to those who claim that they want for us as a people? You have no place with people looking out for us as a people when you are an individualist. You looking out for yourself. And while you doing that, the other folks, these other men coming across the border, your children will be asking them for a job. Your DNA. But you so smart. The inevitable fall of Angel Snuffing Up 7. There's nowhere for me to fall. I'm on the ground. Now, if you can say the fall of the Nation of Islam, they were organized. They had thousands and thousands of people, and they were up at a certain height, and you saw them rise and you saw them fall. I'm just a little guy that's making videos. I'm just a little guy that's making videos. My rhetoric and what I represent, these folks can't handle. Because they just talk. That's why I find myself where I'm at today, because I'm sick of people around me. All that they want to do is talk. But as soon as you say, let's do this and put the pressure on, we got to do, they disappear. Because they don't really believe in nothing. And they want something for nothing. Waiting on Tom and Jerry to do something. Tom and Jerry will do that. Lazy, trifling folks. We could do better than the Mississippi campaign. I introduced that vision, that proposal in 2018. This is 2024. What have they done? You better, you smarter. The people with all the subscribers and getting all the money. What have they done since 2018? Laughing and giggling. It's because of pride. What is that old saying? Pride before the fall. Grandiose and narcissistic. You rather have nothing. You rather die than give credit to your brother. This just didn't fall out the sky. Didn't come from nowhere. It come from over 40 some years of experience in the struggle. Learning from the mistakes. Learning from the failures. This didn't come from because I read a book yesterday and this sound good. I didn't have nothing to offer you in 2010. I didn't know what to do in 2007. I had nothing in 2011 or 2016. I understood that what we got ain't working. But I didn't really know what to do. But now, these folks are really pissed off because now I know what to do. So now it's complete. And it's not for me because I'm not an individual. It's for us. It can work because it was working for our ancestors. The only thing I have done was put a name and a label on it. And a proposal on it, on an activity that our ancestors was doing anyway, and they were succeeding, they was making progress. The only thing that stopped them, of course, was domestic terrorism in this nation. My downfall, or this continued effort to keep me down, you're only keeping yourself down because those things, these ideas, all that stuff, they is not going to do nothing for you. Do little or nothing for you. You need a new mindset, a new strategy, a new way of looking at things. And you get what you deserve, which is nothing. The inevitable fall of Angel Snuffnup 7 is not going to help you none. You're not going to go. You're not going to get better. You're not going to be successful. That's guaranteed. illusion of intelligence that you have. But then when it's tested, you fail. Sound and intellectual don't mean nothing. You only impress other slaves. If it was a threat to these folks, you would be terminated 100 times, just like Angel Snubnub said. They don't bother you, because they know you ain't talking about nothing except reality, my friend. It's much easier. Woo! Lordy, lordy, lordy. Wow. I don't know where to start. I really don't know where to start. Well, since 2007, I made my first video. And I have been in trouble in these YouTube streets ever since. I've always been told only 10 people listen to me. I've always been told. I mean, since 2007, even though you can find videos with 300, 3,000, 5,000 views, it don't make any difference. Folks always tell me, I'm on Instagram, I'm on Daily Motion, I'm on Vimeo, I'm on Facebook. It don't make any difference. Only 10 people listen to me, and I only get 10 views. It makes you wonder, because there are people who really do get very few views. I mean, really do. 30, 40 views or whatever. They don't really get a lot of attention. Here I am. I only get 10 views. I only have 10 subscribers. But whatever I'm saying, whatever I'm doing, upset people to the point where Google itself get involved. 10 views, 10 subscribers, like, damn. What's up with that? What am I saying? Why am I making folks? I get folks really, really upset. What am I saying? What am I doing to get folks so upset? Because it's mind-boggling. Why would you give attention to somebody with 10 views and 10 subscribers? Why are you going to, if nobody's listening to Angel Snubnub 7, why are you going to go all out your way for copyright infringement if you can find it? Whatever you can do to try to silence Angel Snubnub 7, they go all out there. I don't understand. You have to think about what's going on here. Why do I get folks upset? I want you dead. Death threats. Ever since 2007, all kinds of death threats. False flagging. Lying on me. Slandering. Gossip. A person. And then they turn around. Ain't nobody listening to you. What? Ain't nobody listening to you. So if nobody listening to me, why are you going all out your way to try to slander, spread gossip, false flag, even got Google involved? Angel Snub Nub 7 needs to be destroyed. What the hell? Somebody with 10 subscribers, 10 views. That's the way it's always been ever since 2007. I've reached my pinnacle. What is it that they said? Folks waiting for the downfall. I mean, you already wished death on Angel Snub Nub 7 for years. Now we waiting for the downfall. 10 subscribers, 10 views. Okay, now. So now I'm about to bring myself down. Since Google failed to do it, since the demons of darkness, and now we even have some new members of the demons of darkness, they have failed. They can't do nothing. So now I'm going to have to self-destruct. We're waiting on the inevitable downfall of Angel Snub Nub 7. What is it that you expect to fall? In order for something to fall, it had to risen to a certain height first in order to gain some kind of height in order to fall, correct? Nothing can fall if it's already on the ground, right? You waiting on, or you want, the inevitable fall of Angel Snub Nub 7 when I have never gotten off the ground. Because there have always been forces to keep me on the ground. So how am I going to fall when I've never been up? I cannot fall if I've never been up. I'm like that patch of grass that's trying to grow, and you got cars running over the ground. Every time the grass get a chance, opportunity to try to sprout and get up, here comes some car, run over it. That's what has been happening to me since 2007. You have not gave me fertilizer. Nobody has given me nothing. Nobody has come to help me to rise. I've always been on the ground. That's how it is with new ideas. That's how it is with the new. That's how it is with those who are different. You have those. Your job is to stunt the growth, and you don't want Angel Snub Nub 7. Because see, the thing about it is, once I grow, I never fall. So let's stop him from growing to begin with. So there is no fall. But I'm moving and I'm grooving where you think I have risen and I have not gone anywhere. I'm still the little seed in the earth, trying to move the dirt off myself so I can rise. And I will not fall. You don't have the power. You can't do nothing with me on the ground. With all your running over the grass, you can't do nothing. I'm still growing. I'm still dealing with the powers that keep me down. So if you can't stop.
Hey, where you going?
I'll be back, honey.
When I ask you a question, you answer.
They need that dollar. $2. They need it for real. Buy some clothes and some shoes for all them hungry children they make.
Anybody have any questions of me before I get out of here? Let's see what you guys are saying. What's up, Soul Sister Rona? Hey, Talik. I'm the brother that did my Mike Jackson in Tunica, Mississippi. Hey, now. Hello to Terry. Respect. Bless up. Bless up. Bless up.
Yes, Brother Taylor, if I'm pronouncing that correctly, I am Minister John Cooper. I live in Columbia, South Carolina. And I was watching, someone sent me a video, and I was watching, and I think yours popped up on the sidebar. I never heard of you before. When you get time, give me a call if you can. I did a sermon and finally got a chance to do it at a church. I am a minister, but I'm not in the active in the pulpit. I'm deciding to speak, basically, trying to teach and getting our people ready and those that will listen. And this minister allowed me to do a lesson. This past Tuesday night, basically, my wife said, "Man, you were saying the same thing this guy is saying now, John," and it just blew her mind.
My brother Angel Snubnob 7 at the Reality Temple. And to give props to him, because I listen to all of Angel Snubnob 7's videos, I think that he comes from a different angle. And there's a powerful message in a lot of the videos that he put out, and I try to catch all of them. I look at him as a free thinker and a person that's willing to challenge those of which he don't agree with, or which he may think differently from, and I really respect him for that. He's challenged KBS, and he has also challenged the black supremacy movement as well. And I have nothing against that, because that which cannot be challenged cannot stand and will not stand and will not survive the test of time. How many challenges we can withstand will determine how long we will be able to stand.
Come on.
You can't do nothing with me while I'm a seed sprouting, coming up in the earth. What make you think you're going to do something with me when I have risen? Jealousy and envy. That's what it's about. Narcissist, I'm smarter than you. That's what's wrong with these men with the patriarchal mindset. I got to show you I'm smarter than you. I'm more intelligent than you. That's what it's all about. But then, when they come and have to prove it, you're the one that fought. Because you have this illusion that you're high. So you're the one that actually fall. How are you going to deal with somebody who is original, who is creative, that have a vision and a plan and a purpose, and you repeating some stuff and just making up some fabricated ding-dong ding-a-ling stuff, trying to sound smart? We'll come to the courtroom. Let's see. I pass every test that you put on me. That's why you hate me. That's why you don't like me. But that's the patriarchal mindset. And while you are immature and being a fool, you have men coming across the border. Your children, not mine, because I was smart enough to leave children where they was at. Your children gonna be begging these people that's coming across the border right now for a job. You so smart. How you so smart and you waiting on the great white hope to give you what, really? The great white hope, you might see some kind of benefit in your individual condition, but it does nothing for us as a people. But that's because you're greedy and you're selfish and only looking out for yourself. And then some people do say, I'm the individualist. I'm looking out for myself. I'm looking out for my family. It's about what I want. So what the hell are you talking to those who claim that they want for us as a people? You have no place with people looking out for us as a people. When you are an individualist, you looking out for yourself. And while you doing that, the other folks, these other men coming across the border, your children will be asking them for a job. Your DNA, but you so smart. The inevitable fall of Angel Snuffin' Up 7. There's nowhere for me to fall. I'm on the ground. Now, if you can say the fall of the Nation of Islam, they were organized. They had thousands and thousands of people, and they were up at a certain height, and you saw them rise and you saw them fall. I'm just a little guy that's making videos. I'm just a little guy that's making videos. My rhetoric and what I represent, these folks can't handle. Because they just talk. That's why I find myself where I'm at today, because I'm sick of people around me. All they want to do is talk. But as soon as you say, let's do this and put the pressure on, we got to do, they disappear. Because they don't really believe in nothing. And they want something for nothing. Waiting on Tom and Jerry to do something. Tom and Jerry will do that. Lazy, trifling folks. We can do better than the Mississippi campaign. I introduced that vision that proposal in 2018. This is 2024. What have they done? You better, you smarter. The people with all the subscribers and getting all the money. What have they done since 2018? Laughing and giggling. It's because of pride. What is that old saying? Pride before the fall. Grandiose and narcissistic. You rather have nothing. You rather die than give credit to your brother. This just didn't fall out the sky. Didn't come from nowhere. It come from over 40 some years of experience in the struggle. Learning from the mistakes. Learning from the failures. This didn't come from because I read a book yesterday and this sound good. I didn't have nothing to offer you in 2010. I didn't know what to do in 2007. I had nothing in 2011 or 2016. I understood that what we got ain't working. But I didn't really know what to do. But now, these folks are really pissed off because now I know what to do. So now it's complete. And it's not for me because I'm not an individual. It's for us. It can work because it was working for our ancestors. The only thing I have done was put a name and a label on it. And a proposal on it, on an activity that our ancestors was doing anyway, and they were succeeding, they was making progress. The only thing that stopped them, of course, was domestic terrorism in this nation. My downfall, or this continued effort to keep me down, you're only keeping yourself down because those things, these ideas, all that stuff, they is not going to do nothing for you. Do little or nothing for you. You need a new mindset, a new strategy, a new way of looking at things. And you get what you deserve, which is nothing. The inevitable fall of Angel Snuff Nup 7 is not going to help you none. You're not going to go. You're not going to get better. You're not going to be successful. That's guaranteed. That illusion of intelligence that you have. But then when it's tested, you fail. Sound and intellectual don't mean nothing. You only impress other slaves. If it was a threat to these folks, you would be terminated 100 times just like Angel Snuff Nup 7. They don't bother you. Because they know you ain't talking about nothing.
But you, a lot of your video content to me was very informative. You know, the things you talked about had substance, man. And I first really knew about you because of JT Rally 1, Real Nigga News. And you and him got into a conflict with each other. And when I did my website, you were the only brother. And let me stress that. Because when I did that website, blackcommune.net, and I did the video and I asked the black YouTube community, the so-called black YouTube community, to give me your videos. Because at the time, a lot of brothers were getting flagged and videos taken down. So I said, you know what? You can put your videos on my website so that the message can still be heard for all to hear. You know, something like, you know, a little I made that website for everyone. But you were the only one that gave me permission to use your videos. And I thought that was very honorable of you and really a testament to how much you cared about the black community.
Greetings. I'm Tangelika Cox. I had the pleasure of speaking with Talik Ibn Rod, and you know, he has a movement / ministry by the name of the Reality Temple on Earth. And I had the pleasure of speaking with him for several hours today. And I think it's only fair that I do a reaction video to the conversation. And the conversation was on various topics, which was basically centered around African, quote-unquote, consciousness. And he was a real, real deep brother, very down-to-earth, very approachable. He didn't carry himself like a know-it-all. Someone you could talk to and really listen to you. It was such an honor to finally meet somebody over the internet that has a ear to listen, and not only an ear to listen, but will take full action on what they stand for. And I appreciate it having that conversation with you, and I do look forward to working with you.
Dragon Manifest, welcome to the Reality Temple on Earth, Dragon Manifest.
Thank you for having me, brother. This is an honor. When I first saw your channel, I said, oh, this is an ancestor that has most definitely returned. Yes, most definitely. This is not a new ancestor. This is an old ancestor. you could feel the ancestors through you. You know, most people probably say, what is he talking about?
Right.
They don't get it. You gotta be on that level.
If you say that I'm divine and I'm a prophet, where the hell did your ass go to? Why aren't you heeding the call? Since I'm a prophet, since I'm divine. Some people, excuse the language, some people just like talking out their ass. 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 That's what they like to do.
Peace forever and always. My black people, it's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody moving.
We didn't have a choice. We was already doing for ourselves. Even with all the oppression, we were accomplishing things. Far greater than the black and blacks have done. They've done very little. Except bring you the teaching, the belief. Because that's all teachings is, I believe. We don't need to believe no more. We need to know. We'll be right back.
Hi, my name is Deborah Kennedy. I live in Texas, and I listened to Talik's video regarding failure of prayer and God's so-called promises. Things. I was just delighted. I thought it was just very insightful, and I commend you all for putting something out there like that, that we just lean too much on what we're told somebody else is looking out for us. And we have philosophies or teachings like that, and we're supposed to be developing that in ourselves. And I appreciate Talik's powerful delivery. You don't need to call if you're busy, but I just want to pass that along. I'm very impressed. Thank you so much. You take care now. Peace and love.
Hope you'll climb aboard next week on these same stations, and you can bet your last money it's all going to be a stone gas, honey. Always in parting, we're going to wish you love, peace, and soul.
Always in parting, we wish you love, peace, and soul.